Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Are you tired, weak, dizzy, short of breath? According to the American Heart Association, you might have bradycardia. It is a heart rate that is too slow, which can cause an insufficient amount of blood flow to the brain. Joining us to talk about this is Dr. Poulina Uddin. She's a cardiologist with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group in La Jolla, California. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, Susan.
So what causes this slow heart rate, and why do you need to be concerned about it?
You know, that's a great question. So for some people, it's normal to have a slow heart rate. For example, people who are very conditioned athletes who exercise a lot can have a resting slow heart rate, sometimes even in the 50s, 40s, and that's perfectly okay. For other people, it can be part of the natural aging process. The electrical wiring, so to speak, can kind of slow down in the heart as we go through the aging process, and that can cause just the natural heartbeat to slow down. Interestingly, it can also cause sometimes people to skip some beats or miss a beat, certain types of arrhythmias. And so when you check the heart rate, it can appear too slow, either just because the heart rate is too slow or because people are actually dropping or skipping some beats. And there's different ways to figure out what's going on and whether or not that's important.
And who is most at risk?
Usually this is something that comes with age, like a lot of things. So in general, as people go on through time, sometimes their heart rate can slow down. So we do look for this and see this as part of the natural aging process of the heart rate, either slowing down or getting some of those conduction abnormalities that we talked about, where the top and the bottom don't connect. But there are a few rare circumstances where young, you know, people under the age of 30, or even sometimes children can get this because of conditions that they can be born with. And that's a little bit less common, but we most of the time see this as people get a little bit older.
So if a slow heart rate is associated with folks who are really athletic, how do you know when the heart rate is too slow and that's not a good thing?
That's a great question. So when you just get your heart rate checked or get an EKG, anytime the heart rate comes back as less than 60 beats per minute, that's considered bradycardia. However, we really only get concerned about a slow heart rate if people are symptomatic. And what I mean by that is feeling unexplained fatigue, really tired, sometimes lightheaded or dizzy, in really severe cases, actually fainting or passing out, or some people report difficulty exercising. They say they feel they can't have enough energy or get their heart rate up when they try to exercise. In those situations, bradycardia or a slow heart rate can actually be a problem. And in some circumstances, we would want to follow that up further.
But there's lots of things that can make you tired or dizzy or short of breath. How do you know that it's something you really need to get checked out?
You're right. They're very vague symptoms. So we have a lot of useful tools that we use. For example, we can put an external heart monitor on. We have things that look like this in the office that we can send you home with that you wear for 1 to 2 weeks, up to 30 days to let us know what is your heart rate doing over time. We have longer term monitors depending on the situation. There's some little ones like this actually that can actually get implanted under the skin that can stay in for several years and monitor the heart rate and send a notification to your doctor's office if the heart rate is either too fast or too slow. And then of course, nowadays, people can monitor themselves with certain things like their watches and things like that. And basically, we don't react just to a slow heart rate. But if the heart rate is slow at the time that people are also experiencing these symptoms and we can't think of any other reason for it, then we can attribute the fatigue or the lightheadedness to the slow heart rate. If somebody is just sitting around with a slow heart rate feeling great, we don't necessarily worry about it.
But when you associate this slow heart rate with an insufficient amount of blood flow through to the brain, what can happen?
So if somebody really has a slow heart rate that's causing not enough blood to get to the brain, oftentimes we find that it's not just that the heart rate is slow. They might sometimes actually have what we call arrhythmia, where they drop or skip a beat once in a while, or not a lot, all of the heartbeats get through. So for example, in your heart, you have your natural pacemaker that's up in the top chambers of the heart sitting somewhere up in here. And your heart actually follows these electrical pathways for the heartbeat to go from top to bottom. So sometimes we find that the beats that are starting in the top aren't making all their way to the bottom. Sometimes we find that actually your own pacemaker has slowed down. And so all the beats are getting through, but just the heart rate is too slow. In either way, if your heart rate is so slow that you're not pumping enough blood to get to your brain, usually those people will say, I just don't have the energy to do what I want through the day. I feel listless, I feel tired. And just like you said, first we check and make sure there's not other reasons that people are feeling tired. We check their blood work, you know, we actually check the heart function, because you can have a slow heart rate and still have normal heart function, but then at the end of the day, you're not getting enough blood to the brain and you can feel tired.
So how do you treat this condition if you've been diagnosed with bradycardia?
So if you're diagnosed with bradycardia, the first important thing is to figure out what type of bradycardia it is, whether it's just the heart rate too slow or you're actually dropping and skipping beats. So the first thing you would want to do is see your doctor, depending on how poorly you feel or how good you feel, get one of these different types of heart monitors, either this one, maybe this one. If need be, if it turns out that you need a pacemaker, which a lot of people do, that can certainly sometimes make people feel better. There's different types of pacemakers. This is an example of one that gets implanted here and goes actually into the heart muscle. Here's another example of a tiny little one. Hopefully you can see that can actually go into the heart itself that doesn't have the leads. And depending on the circumstance, think of a pacemaker as a backup generator. So your heartbeat can still do what it needs to do, but the pacemaker kicks in the background and gives you a little bit oomph to your heart rate as needed. There are circumstances where people's heart rate is slow all the time versus intermittently, and that's where the pacemaker can kick in.
If you have one of these implantable devices, what's the recovery time from that surgery?
That's a great question. Most of the time, people spend one night in the hospital and then go home the following day. But usually, especially if you get the pacemaker implanted under the skin, which is the most common type, we ask that people don't do any driving or heavy lifting or swimming for about 2 weeks to give that a chance to recover properly. And then hopefully you can go about your normal business.
So when should you go see the doctor? And then when should you say, now I need to go to the emergency room?
If you are actually fainting or passing out or feel like you're going to, I think that's a very good time to go to the emergency room. If you're just feeling a little run down and you're not entirely sure why, I think it's reasonable to make an appointment with your doctor to get an EKG, to verify the heart rate, maybe look for other reasons you could be tired. You know, check blood work, make sure you're not anemic. Those are different reasons people can feel tired. And then maybe consider one of these monitoring devices to try to tease out what's the actual cause of the fatigue.
If left untreated, this slow heart rate, what can happen?
So if people are asymptomatic, meaning they don't have any symptoms with this slow heart rate, oftentimes they can do fine, especially if, like we talked about, it's one of those athletes who just has a slow heart rate from running, they can do great. However, if it's actually one of these types of heart block where the beat doesn't get through from the top to the bottom, you know, it usually progresses. People feel worse over time, more tired, more fatigued. And then unfortunately, people can actually faint or pass out and really get injured in that way as well. So if it is something that's causing symptoms, it's really worth getting checked out just to be on the safe side.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
I would say in general with bradycardia, as with most conditions, I think if you feel a change in your baseline, you know, if you were saying, hey, I felt fine last week and this week I just can't even get out of bed, or I can't go for my walk with my dog, you know, if something is different than your baseline, it may or may not be heart related, but the heart, we think, is obviously a very important structure. So if you're unsure and you feel different than what you're used to feeling, definitely let your doctor know.
Doctor, thanks very much for taking the time. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
If you want to learn more about this slow heart rate, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.